Hello friends, in this session we will learn timers of LPC2148 ARM. LPC2148 has two timers. Names are timer 0 and timer 1. Both timers are of 32 bit. This timer can count number of pulses coming from P clock. P clock means peripheral clock, as well as it can count number of pulses coming from external sources. External sources means outside LPC2148. To get lower frequency from the output, there is a facility of prescaler. In this session, we will keep prescaler value as a 0. Timer 0 and timer 1 has two different sets of special function registers. Suppose we are learning timer 0, then we have to use 4 different registers to configure timer 0. The first register is a timer count register. It is also referred as 20TC. Second register is a timer control register. It is also referred as T0TCR. Third, match register. For timer 0 and timer 1, 4 match registers are available. Next one, match control register. It is also referred as T0MCR. Now let's discuss timer count register T0TC. It is a 32-bit register. It can count the value from 0 to FFFFFFFF. Its value will increase by 1 every after 1 tick of peripheral clock or every after 1 tick of external source. Assume that prescaler value is made 0. Second one is a timer control register T0TCR. It has 2 bits. One of the bit is a E and another bit is a R. E means enable and R means reset. When enable bit is made 1, then automatically timer value will increase by 1 after 1 tick of P clock. Whereas if R bit is made 1, then timer value will suddenly become 0 at next positive edge of peripheral clock. Match register. LPC2148 has 4 different match registers. Names are MR0 to MR3. Suppose we are using MR0, means MR0 value will get compared with timer count register T0TC. If these two values are matching, then certain action can be taken by using program. Next one is a match control register T0MCR. This register is used to specify certain action after match occurred. It has 3 bits, I bit, R bit and S bit. If I bit is made 1, then interrupt will occur after match. Suppose R bit is made 1, then timer value, that is the T0 TCR value, become 0 after match. If bit 2, that is the S bit, is made 1, then T0 TC and prescaler value will get stopped and E bit in T0 TCR will become 0. This is the plot diagram of timer. Assume that we are using timer 0 and we are counting peripheral clock. Suppose I am having system with peripheral clock frequency 15 MHz and we have to consume time of 1 second. Then we have to find first what value I should load in match register T0MR0. Calculation is given below. I will find first time of 1 cycle of peripheral clock. By frequency 15 MHz, we will find time of 1 clock cycle. In our case, it is 6.6 × 10⁻²⁸ seconds. After that, we will check how many pulses we need to count to consume 1 second time. The formula is time to be consumed upon time of single cycle of peripheral clock. So number of pulses to be count is equal to 1 second upon 6.6 × 10⁻⁸. The answer is 15 × 10⁶ pulses. This value we will load in T0MR0. Up till now we have seen various registers of the timer. Now we will use timer 0 and we will configure it. Very first thing, we will load match value in T0MR0. Then by using T0MCR, we will specify what action we are going to take after match. After that, we will start timer by using E bit of T0 TCR. Our timer will get start and its value will get increase after every tick of P clock. Once match is occurred, we are going to reset the timer. Now we will see what values I should load in various registers. As per our discussion, we have to use compare register T0 MR0. We are going to specify how many pulses we are going to count. In our case, it is a 15 × 10⁶. Next register is a match control register T0 MCR. This register is used to specify what will be done once a match is occurred. In our case, we are going to stop the counter. As we know, there are 3 bits, S, R and I. To stop the counter once match is occurred, we have to make S bit as a 1 and remaining 2 bits as a 0. So hexadecimal equivalent is a 4. Next register is a timer control register T0 TCR. In case if we want to start the timer, we have to make enable bit of this register as a 1 and reset bit as a 0. Therefore, hexadecimal equivalent is a 01. In case if we want to stop the timer, we have to make enable bit as a 0 and therefore hexadecimal equivalent is a 00H. These are the steps to be followed for writing subroutine. First, load T0 MR0 register. In our case, it is a 15 × 10⁶. Next, specify action to be taken once match is occurred. At T0 MCR register, we have to load with the value 4. Next, start the timer by loading T0 TCR value with 01. And now, compare T0 TC and T0 MR0 registers. Once a match is occurred, T0 TC value we have to load with a 0 so that timer will get reset. Eventually, our subroutine will look like this. To debug above mentioned code, we will use kill macrogen 4. So create one folder on any drive. In my case, it is on desktop with the name test. Now open kill macrovision 4, go to the project, new macrovision project, select a folder. In my case, it is on desktop with name test. Give name to the project. I am given name as a project. Click on save. It will ask for a particular chip. In my case, it is a LPC2148. Select this chip and say OK. It will give one message, say yes. Now go to the file and take new file. Here in this file we should write our program. In my case, I will copy it which is already written and I will paste in editor window. Now save this file. So click on save as. When we are giving name, that time extension should be C. That's why I have given name as a program.c. Save it. Now we have to add this file to the our project. So link it. So click on program, add and close. Now go to the target 1, right click, choose very first option for target 1. Click on output. Enable create hex file, go to the linker, enable use memory layout from target dialog, say OK. This is our program. In my program, in this line, port 0 is made as a output port. In this line, all pins of port 0s are made high. After that, delay is called, which is of 1 second. Next, port 0 is made low and once again delay subroutine is called and this procedure is done forever. Whatever delay subroutine we have discussed, that is written here. Now compile this file So click on build all. There is no error and no warning, so we can go for debug. So go to the debug, click on start stop debug session. It will give one message, say OK. Now click on setup. Now click on setup. Now click here and specify pin number which is to be observed. In my case, port 0.0, and press enter. Select this pin and specify display type as a bit. Click on close and now run our program. We have to run this for at least 3 seconds so that we can observe the high time as well as low time. So duration of run is around 3 seconds. Now I will stop the debug session and now click on zoom out so that we can observe high time as well as low time. Now look at the edges. This is a negative edge. Here negative edge is at 1.000017, whereas high edge or positive edge is at 2.000017. Next negative edge is at 3.000018. So in this way, we have successfully created a delay of 1 second by using LPC2148, and we have debugged the session by using Keil Microvision 4. Thanks for watching my video. I have taken reference from a book, Leila Das, Embedded System and Integrated Approach, Pearson Publication, 1st edition, 2013.